If I asked you to close your eyes and imagine some wildlife, you'd probably conjure up an image similar to this. Or even this. The focus of your visualization was most likely the cute little fox, rather than the digitalis plant, or the conium maculatum plant. Well, you're not alone in this. A 2016 study showed that study participants remember images of animals better than they remember images of plants.
We've never been at this point of disconnection and estrangement from the natural world before.
We're surrounded by synthetic and electronic entertainment, and we don't interact with plants and nature as we once would have had we been growing our own food or hunting for our own food. And this has resulted in what is known as the nature deficit disorder, where people don't recognize plants at all, other than something that they may consume for dinner. The human eye sees green a lot easier than any other color, so it tends to group green objects together and fade them into the background. And then there's the evolutionary development within humans that early humans were threatened by animals. We also had to look out for movement, for a fast-moving lion coming to eat us. Therefore, the human eye picks up movement and looks for movement. So we often don't recognize plants which are relatively unmoving.
Connecting with nature affects us from our heads to our toes, from microbacteria in the soil, which studies show can enhance well-being, to petrichor, the smell of the earth after it's rained, to the sound of birdsong, which has been found to decrease the stress hormone cortisol. I realised I was disconnected from the natural world about 8 years ago, during a period of recovery from depression and addiction issues. I found myself drawn to walking daily on Walthamstow marshes, and the experience of being in nature and walking on the marshes became as important and as therapeutic as the medication, the psychotherapy, and the support of friends and family. Those who have less access to outdoor space, and 2.5 million people in Britain don't live within easy 10-minute walking distance of a green space, have fewer opportunities to decrease their stress through contact and connection with the natural world.
So every year, more plant species go extinct than animal species, and in fact, CITES, which is the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Wild Species, that's fauna and flora, has 30,000 plant species listed compared to the 5,000 animal species, which are in danger of extinction from legal and illegal trade. Plants and fungi are the foundation on which humans and animals really depend, and yet they're not recognized, and they are the underdogs. They just keep toiling away and keeping us alive.
You don't need anything to go out in nature. You just need to find something that you're interested or curious in. I love insects and lichen and moss, so I'm always looking around for different species I can find and patterns and shapes. So I'd say just find something that makes you feel wonder and awe and say wow, and just continue your lines of curiosity.
Plants are essential to us. They're not just a green background or something for us or animals to eat. They are significant in our survival as a species and as a planet.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon.